I want to talk about keeping on schools, but about vaccines in schools. Virginia public schools are required, children are required there to get vaccinated for a lot of things, including polio and measles and chickenpox. So why is it okay to mandate childhood vaccines in Virginia for so many diseases, but not COVID?
Well, let's ask ourselves, and I'm not saying yay or nay, let's ask ourselves, if the purpose of the COVID vaccine is to prevent us from getting COVID, then why is it that those who have had COVID must get the vaccine? The one doesn't follow the other. And so, you know, there are people who, when they get COVID, they also get the monoclonal antibody therapy, and it's working. It's working very well in Florida, if you notice what's happening there. And so one size doesn't fit all. Now, I have said, get the vaccine. And then if you're not gonna get the vaccine, then, you know, do what's necessary to keep yourself safe, keep other people safe. But let me ask you this question. If you have the mask on, then why does somebody else have to wear the mask? You've got the mask, you've got the vaccine. My God, you're fully protected. You're armored. I think ultimately we have to remember that we're America. We love our freedom. We love our liberty. People are dying to get into this country so that they can do well for themselves and their families. Let's not make it like some other countries. Let's let liberty shine.
So just a couple of things that you said there. You said that people who have had COVID have the antibodies. That is true, but scientists don't think that lasts forever, and eventually they wane, just like the antibodies you get from your vaccine wanes, which is why people are getting boosters. But my question from the beginning was about the fact you talk about liberty, but there are already mandates for vaccines for a host of other diseases. So is COVID just becoming too political, especially as you even said, you want people to get vaccinated?
I'm not going to force anybody to do that. Now, you talk about it's become politicized as COVID-19 vaccine, and it has. In fact, our president, President Biden, and Vice President Harris themselves both said they would not trust any vaccine that was developed by the Trump administration. That was before their election. After their election, they were singing a different song. And now everybody has to be vaccinated. In fact, President Biden, when he was candidate Biden, said that he would not force vaccines on us, and here we are. I mean, what are we really believing? Then we say we're gonna go along with whatever the health and the sciences say. Well, then his very own FDA, 16-2, voted against booster shots. Then what happens? He comes out, his CDC director says they're gonna have booster shots. What science are we following? Then we hear that at the border, people are coming in, COVID, no mask, no anything, and they're being let into the general population. But then the rest of us who are here have to mask up. What is the science? Can somebody tell us what to finally believe?
Yeah.
This is the problem. It is all politicized.
Yeah, well, in fairness, the science, it's a novel virus, and the science is changing, and scientists are learning about it. I just have to say that you said that the candidate Biden said that he wouldn't trust the Trump vaccine. What they said was that they would only trust it if the scientists determined it, not the politicians. But just before I let you go on this topic, during the campaign, you were, as I said, you're encouraging people to get vaccinated, but you're not saying whether you are vaccinated. Do you want to say now?
As I said, America, if it's nothing else, it's about liberty. It's about being able to live your life free from the government telling you what to do. And so we understand this thing about slippery slopes. The minute that I start telling you about my vaccine status, we're gonna be down the bottom of the mountain trying to figure out how we got there, because now you wanna know what's in my DNA. You're gonna wanna know this, that, and the other. In New York, you see, we have people, waiters asking people their vaccination status. And by the way, do you know what else they require? A photo ID to determine if this vaccine card you're presenting is really you. Who are we fooling? Come on. Let's say you get the vaccine. Go ahead and get the vaccine. If that's what you want to do, get the vaccine. Don't force it on anybody else. We know. And by the way, media, they're not telling us that people are suffering as a result of getting the vaccine. They have all kinds of problems. So, I understand it might be the minuscule, but when you're the one out of 30,000 that gets it, it's important to you. So we need to tell the good, the bad, and the ugly about the vaccine.